What's going on, guys? Psycho Killer here, and welcome back to my Red Dead Online Rags to Riches series, Psycho Goes West. We've made it, the last episode, and in this episode, we're just going to cover some loose ends. We're going to talk about some of the quick ways to help out with your money-making and gold-making progress, and without wasting any time, let's actually get into it. So the first thing I want to point out is one of the most overlooked things that you can do to make gold, and that is trading in your award points and resetting them for gold nuggets. And to do so, all you have to do is go to the pause menu and go to progress and then awards. And each one of these little sections has a list of awards in them, where if you go in there and go to the award, if it's gold, some of them, most of them, have the option to press the action button and hold it to reset the award. Most of them trade in for 24 gold nuggets. In addition to that, bounty hunters that are over rank 30 can trade in every 10,000 bounty hunter points, bounty hunter XP, you can trade in for 50 gold nuggets. And you do this the same way. You go to the pause menu, go to progress and awards, and then go to bounty hunter, and it's going to be on the bottom left. Moving on, a helpful tip for moonshine sales. If you have somebody to ride with you, and right ahead of the wagon, they are able to take out the roadblock before the wagon gets there, thus preventing the chances of destroying any of your moonshine. After the roadblock is taken out, they can then ride behind the wagon to protect the wagon from oncoming revenue agents. Quick tips for the trader role. If you use legendary animals, whether it's through sighting missions or found in free roam, to fill up your materials, they'll fill up so much faster with so much less effort. That way you don't got to spend so much time hunting. In addition to that, if you order your supplies, it'll move a lot faster. And to get past the waiting period for your supplies to deliver, all you have to do is order your supplies and then switch sessions just by going to the pause menu online and then selecting your camp or anywhere else to spawn inside the free world in a new session, and your supplies will be automatically delivered. Furthermore, your trader role is always a lot easier to deliver with friends. If you have somebody ride on the wagon with you, and then people ride ahead of and behind, the chances of being taken out by rival players are a lot slimmer. And of course, when you do your trader sales, if available, you always want to make sure you have some explosive ammo. It's a lot easier to take somebody and their horse out and get away with explosive ammo. And of course, like I just mentioned, when you are attacked by other players while doing a trader sell, take their horse out. I don't normally condone destroying people's horses. However, if they're attacking you and you take their horse out, the chances are that it's going to take them a minute to get back on that horse and catch back up to you. Not everybody has two horses and two saddles ready to go at any given moment. Beyond any of this, of course, as I've said before, you want to do your daily challenges every single day, as many of them as you can. The higher up you rank in your roles, the more daily challenges for those roles become available, and you're able to do a total of 9 role challenges per day. You also want to make sure you are checking your post box, either at the post office or the lockbox at your camp, and checking your inventory for treasure maps, and do treasure maps as much as possible. You can also do bounty hunts, the legendary bounties, every hour, and you can cycle through the infamous bounties through town to town to maximize your gold intake. So if you're grinding gold, bounty hunter, treasure maps, awards, and daily challenges are your best friend. And if you're grinding cash, the collector role is the best active income for grinding cash, and the trader and moonshine are amazing passive incomes. If you want to know when your moonshine is ready, the best way to know if you're going to be AFK, set a timer for roughly 48 minutes for 3-star moonshine with the most potent possibility. So that's all the tips and tricks I've got for you guys in this video. And yo, if this series is helpful for you at all, go ahead and give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you're new around here and turn your notifications on. That way you don't miss the notification when I upload my next series. I'm not sure what it's going to be yet. But I've got some ideas, and I think you guys are going to like it. But with all that said, my dudes, as always, I will see you on the flip side.